Are you ready to discover the meaning of the Moon Tarot card? Well, in this video, I'm going to reveal exactly what this card means in any kind of reading, whether it's about love, career, finance, spirituality, or just a general reading. Plus, I'm going to show you how to interpret this card when it's upright or it's reversed, so that way you will never get stuck on this card again. So let's dive in. Now, the Moon represents illusion, fear, anxiety, subconscious and intuition. And this card shows a full moon in the night sky, and it's positioned between two large towers. Now, these towers are a symbolic path to the higher consciousness that is winding along that way. And in the foreground, you can see a small pool, and it represents the watery nature of the subconscious mind. You'll see a small crayfish that's crawling out of the pool, and this symbolizes the early stages of consciousness that are unfolding. And then there's a dog and a wolf standing in the grassy field, and they're howling at the moon. Now, these both represent the tamed and wild aspects of our mind. So the moon represents your fears and your illusions, and it often comes out when you're projecting those past fears into your present and your future. So you might have a painful memory that's caused emotional distress, but rather than dealing with the emotions, you've pushed them down deep into the subconscious mind. So the Moon card shows that these emotions are now starting to make a reappearance. So you may be finding yourself that you're under their influence on a conscious or a subconscious level. So maybe, like, for example, you had a car accident when you were young, but you didn't deal with the emotions. And you may even get sad or anxious every time you get into the back seat of a car. Now, to remedy this, you need to connect with your subconscious mind and release any fears or anxieties that are holding you back. And you might like to try something like hypnosis, therapy, or even shamanic healing to support this process. Now, the moon can indicate a time of uncertainty and illusion when nothing is what it seems. So be careful of making some quick decisions when this card appears, because you may realize that later you only actually had half the information that you needed. The key is to listen to and trust your intuition so that you can see beyond what's just in front of you. So feel into the situation rather than just thinking into that situation. And let go of any of your conscious mental blocks or negative self-talk, and allow your intuition to guide you instead. Because this is your opportunity to let your dreams, your intuition, your inner guidance to lead you forward towards higher levels of understanding by using your judgment to help interpret the messages that your subconscious is giving you. Now, when the Moon card appears in your tarot reading, pay close attention to, you guessed it, the lunar cycles. So attune to the Moon's divine power using things like ritual, visualization, or even tarot readings, of course, because you're being asked to connect with the divine feminine. And this is going to help you uncover deep intuitive insights and visions of what lies beyond everyday life. So on the new moon, set your intentions and plant those seeds of opportunity so they can grow. And then on the full moon, honor your achievements and look at what you need to release so that new aspects of yourself can really shine through. Now, when it comes to relationships and love, the moon card can suggest illusions and deception. So if you're looking for love, don't take things on face value. Dig a little bit deeper to see what's really going on underneath the surface. Because if something does seem off, then it probably is, and you need to be careful that you don't get swept up in the excitement of finding someone only to realize that that relationship is not what you thought it was. So the moon is telling you that it's not a good time to be making decisions about long-term commitments. Now, if you are in a long-term relationship already, then the moon card can suggest that emotional issues are affecting that relationship, things like anxiety, depression, or even mental health concerns. And you may also start to unearth some long buried secrets that maybe you are unaware of, or even if you have been together for a long time, now these are just starting to become illuminated. Now, when it comes to career, work, and finances, the moon can signal that all is not as it seems. There may be a bit of shady business dealings or even fraudulent activities or hidden agendas going on that you're either not aware of or that you're choosing to ignore. Now, the message is don't take things at face value. You've got to trust your intuition and your gut instinct, particularly if something doesn't feel right. Now, on a more personal level, you may be uncertain about where your career is headed and you have a bit of no guidance. You're not sure where it's going. So you know that you've got to keep progressing, but you don't really know what your long-term goals are. And financially, the moon advises against making any major decisions right now, because it's likely that you don't have all the information that you need, or that things are not quite as straightforward as you think. So you've got to be careful of people's hidden agendas that may affect your finances. Now, if you see the moon in a spiritual reading, it shows you that you really are in tune with your intuition. So you might receive psychic messages and downloads through meditation, self-hypnosis, or also your dreams. Now, some of you may also be more open to receiving psychic readings and connections so that you can stay in tune with your intuition. So just be open to this and be ready to receive all of those messages. Now, this card also calls on you to align yourself with the lunar cycles to really aid your spiritual development, because the energy of the moon can be used to seed your intentions, manifest your goals, and release any limitations. Now, what if you see the moon reversed in your tarot reading? Well, on one level, the reversed moon shows you that you've been dealing with illusion, fears, and anxiety, and now the negative influences of those energies are actually subsiding. So you're being asked to work through these limiting beliefs so that you can understand the impact that they have on your life and learn how to free yourself from them. Now, this is a truly liberating and transformational experience if you really surrender to it. Now, on the other hand, the moon reverse shows that you might be trying to bury these feelings even deeper within your subconscious so that you can avoid any of those dark shadows. Maybe you're not ready to face your emotions, so you're just pushing them to the side and you're just trying to pretend like nothing's wrong. Now, here's the thing. This strategy might work in the short term, but eventually you're going to need to resurface these emotions and deal with them head on. Now, the moon reverse can also show that you are receiving intuitive messages and psychic downloads, but maybe you're struggling to really understand what they mean for you. So the message may be confusing, or your interpretation differs from what you are reading elsewhere. So when the moon is reversed, you're really being called to listen to your inner voice and not the voice of somebody else. You need to trust that the answers you need are already within you, and you need to be able to tune into your inner guidance system to hear those answers. So pay attention to your dreams. Keep a dream diary, because this is how many of your subconscious messages will actually be relayed to you in this state. And if you find that you're still stuck, then record the messages that you receive and then come back to them later, when you may have a bit more clarity. Now, if you want to learn more about the tarot cards and what they mean, I've got something super special for you. It is my tarot card meanings reference guide, and it's absolutely free. It's going to give you access to all of the card meanings right at your fingertips. All you need to do is click on the link below and you can get instant access and never go blank in a reading again. Now, if you want to learn more about how to read tarot in a more modern and approachable way, there is so much for you to learn here at Vidi Tarot, because we are literally helping millions of people around the world to develop their tarot skills and connect with their intuition. And of course, we'd love to help you do the same. So take the next step in your tarot journey by clicking below. Bye for now. Hey, if you love this video, then make sure you check out this next video and subscribe to our YouTube channel. See you next time.